Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Elhamdülillahi Rabbil alemin. Vessalatu vesselam ala seyyidil mürselin. Seyyidina Muhammed ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ve sellem teslimen kethira. This is Imam Zeyd Shakir, and I'm here on behalf of Lamp Post under the leadership of our beloved colleague, Sheikh Ustaz Abdullah Ali. Abdullah Ali is one of our teachers here at Zaytuna College, and he runs the Lamp Post, as many of you know, discussing in many, some instances, very difficult, controversial issues, the slippery issues, the one it's hard to get a hand on in many instances. He never shies away from taking on any challenge that can provide benefit to the multitudes of believers out there. Brothers and sisters, Lamp Post has started an amazing initiative. That initiative is to support and make accessible the scholarship of indigenous scholars, scholars who have been born, raised, bred here, right here in the United States. Why is that so important, brothers and sisters? As we know, knowledge has never become firmly established in any land until that land began producing its own scholars. If you go to Pakistan, the scholars are Pakistanis. They're not even Indians, they're Pakistanis. If you go to Bangladesh, they're Bengalis, they're not Indians. If you go to India, they're Indians. Even though there's a common South Asian Desi culture, each area has its particular scholars who are attuned and sensitive to the particular issue of that society. If you go to Uzbekistan, the scholars are Uzbek. If you go to Tajikistan, they're Tajik. If you go to Kyrgyzstan, whatever you will call a person in Khaziristan, that's what the scholars are. If you go to Arabia, they're Arabs. And the Saudi Arabia, they're Saudis. If you go to Syria, they're Syrian. They're Shamis. If you go to Iranian, they're Iranian. If you go to Iran, they're Iranian. So you don't go to Iran and there's an American Muslim scholar addressing the people there. They are Iranian. They studied in Qum. They studied in Najaf or wherever, and they came back to serve their people. So if you come to America, the bulk of the scholars should be American. And this isn't a nationalistic statement. This is a cultural statement. This is a religious statement. It's a statement of fact, because only those who are born, raised, understand the nuances, understand the culture, speak the language of the youth and the language of the people here, those are the people, and also have a sound understanding of the religion, those are the people who are going to make the religion stick. And those are also the people, we hope, who will be able to rise above the fray that's consuming so many in so many of our lands. If we're so connected to another land, and that could well be the case, and there's nothing wrong with that, but our first and foremost concerns are going to be those lands we're connected with. So if we're a Syrian scholar and we're here in the United States teaching and serving as an imam or a teacher, our heart, our sentiments, our attachments are back in Syria as our homeland bleeds. And what we can do to support our brothers and sisters there, that's just a statement of fact. That's where our true efficacy lies. How many times has a scholar, a great scholar, come here to the United States for dawah or to teach in a masjid, and that scholar is unused because he doesn't understand the language? So they have an amateur going to the interfaith event to represent the Muslims, and not the great Azhari graduate, Sheikh Fulan in Masjid Fulan. He's not going. He doesn't speak the language. If he speaks the language with some degree of fluency, he doesn't understand the cultural debates. He doesn't understand the intellectual currents that his interlocutors will be engaging with or dealing with. So it's very, very important for us to have our own scholars here to join the community of scholars, not to set ourselves up as some special, unique, untouchable, privileged class who know everything, but as individuals, as a community, a scholarly community of individuals who understand our people.